Good morning, dear friends, especially our dear Bisconians and our dear Salesian educators. This morning I was in the chapel meditating, and one of the things that I saw prominent in my shelves is a copy of this, which you see there also in your screen, The Companion of Youth. And it is the prayer book that is published by the Salesian Commission on Youth Ministry here in the Philippine province of the North. And it is widely used especially by our Bisconians from the Tibet Department all over the Philippines, and especially in the Philippines North. And you would see there in the cover, the title is The Companion of Youth. And of course, the publisher, Salesian Commission on Youth Ministry, the Mnosa Philippines, FIN, Philippines North. And you would see the motto of Don Bosco, "Give me souls, take away the rest." Well, this is the prayer book that is in circulation in our Tibet centers. Once upon a time, when I was a Bisconian, a student of Don Bosco Tarlac, we had what we called the Youth at Prayer. And it was the prayer book that was used all over the Philippines among the Don Bosco schools. And I grew up with it, and I did not know that it was actually an offshoot or a version or an edition of Don Bosco's Companion of Youth. Now, we're reviving the title. Of course, this is an English translation. The title is an English translation from the original, which is Il Giovane Provveduto. I'll tell you more about that in the future. But the first edition came in the time of Don Bosco, and that was in 1847. A later edition is what you see on the screen, which is also quite a bit old in its the date of publication, but it's among the first. And you would see there at the frontispiece, Saint Aloysius Gonzaga, because he was made as a model for the young people at that time of Don Bosco. Now I'd like to read, as the message for this, the good morning talk for today, a message from Don Bosco that you would read in The Companion of Youth that we have right now. And we would see there, message from Don Bosco, and here it goes. "Dear young people, the devil uses two tricks in particular to discourage young people from leading good lives. The first is to make them think that serving God represents a sad life, far removed from fun and excitement. My dear young people, that's not true. I want to teach you a way of living the Christian life that will make you happy and contented, by showing you what real amusement and real pleasure are, so that you will be able to say with the holy prophet David, 'Serve the Lord with gladness.' This is in fact my reason for writing this book, so that you may serve the Lord and be always cheerful. The second trick used by the devil is the hope of living a long life with a chance of changing one's ways in old age or in the point of death. Take care, my children. There are many who have been deceived in this way. Who can assure you that you will live to old age? Life and death are in God's hands. And even if God grants you a long life, listen to what He tells you. Start a child on the right road. Even in old age, he will not leave it. This means that if we begin living a good life now that we are young, good will be our old age. Good will be our death, which will be the beginning of eternal happiness. On the other hand, if bad habits take possession of us in our youth, generally speaking, they will stay with us over the years to our old age. A sorry down payment on a miserable eternity. In order that such a terrible thing does not happen to you, I am offering you a plan for life that is simple and easy to carry out, but good enough to allow you to become the consolation of your family, a credit to your country, good citizens of this world, so that you may one day be happy citizens of heaven. My dear friends, I love you with all my heart. It is enough for you to be young for me to love you very much. I can assure you, you will find books written for you by persons who are much more virtuous and clever than I. But you will struggle to find anyone who loves you in Jesus Christ more than I do, or who wants to see you truly happy more than I do. May the Lord be with you and see to it that by putting these few suggestions into practice, you may come to save your soul and so give greater glory to God, which is the only reason why I have compiled this work. Live happy. The Lord be with you. Yours affectionately in Jesus Christ, Don Bosco. Beautiful words as an introduction to Il Giovane Provveduto, to the companion of youth. And you see, that's actually the message that he imparted at the beginning of that book, in the first edition of which was in 1847. By the way, among the BED, Basic Education Department here in Don Bosco Canlubang, we have included the prayers within the student's handbook. That was in the past recent years. Of course, they will still be providing you for this school year with that handbook, a valuable tool for prayer, a companion of youth, really. And you will see there the rules and regulations, and also you will see there correspondences that you could make. But what's important is that it's part and it's an offshoot of Don Bosco's work. And here, what does the work contain? It's for the young people, and they contain advice, religious instruction, prayers, liturgical texts, and hymns. And the title is Il Giovane Provveduto. It's translated very awkwardly in English. If you say Il Giovane Provveduto, the young provided for. But I think the English translators, later on, especially from the Anglophone countries, they have translated it to the companion of youth, which is very apt that it goes with young people. And the work has had more than 100 editions and was translated into many languages and updated like what we have here. I wish you all the best today. Have a great day. Have a great week ahead of you. God bless you.